Selecting the appropriate equipment and medications for infant and child intubation is vital. Many providers have historically preferred to use uncuffed ET tubes for infants and children because the normal pediatric airway narrows below the vocal cords. Now, this creates an anatomical seal around the distal end of the tube. What happens often in settings such as pre-hospital or where the patient is moved around, uncuffed ET tubes may need to be changed to cuffed ET tubes in order to maintain a patent airway. The benefit of using cuffed tubes in the beginning of a resuscitation for pediatric patients are that it improves accuracy of capnography, better tidal volume delivery, and reductions for the need for a potential tube change. Reintubation is a high-risk procedure that should be avoided whenever possible. Using a cuffed tube can decrease the risk of airway trauma by decreasing the need for tube changes. Cuffed ETTs may also decrease the risk of aspiration. However, cuffed tubes can cause airway damage when too high of a pressure is used in the cuff. Careful attention must be made to select the correct tube size, position, and cuff inflation pressure. Cuff inflation pressure should normally be less than 20 to 25 centimeters of H2O. It's also important to consider that ET tube cuff pressures will change during transport, varying altitudes, and with increasing airway edema. After placing a tube, it's important to verify proper tube placement. Auscultation of breath sounds, mist in the tube, or chest rise may be good indicators of proper placement. However, for patients with a PALS, these are not the most reliable signs. Either a colorimetric detector or capnography should be used to assess initial placement. Another point to consider when managing an infant or child's airway is that cricoid pressure during bag mask ventilation and intubation is really not recommended, even though it has historically been used to minimize the risk of gastric contents refluxing into the airway. It may actually reduce effective bag mask ventilation and significantly reduce the success of intubation.